So here is the beam. As you can see, it's a 12 feet beam. It's coming until here, and here it connects to other beam. Okay, and as you can see in the beam, you can see there are holes where the cross T will get in, okay? And what's nice in that, the holes here, actually, the distance between the holes is actually exactly half a foot, okay? So that's it, it's going until the end. What happened here, every 4 feet, we're putting a beam. That's another beam here, you can see. Every 4 feet, we're putting beam. So remember, the beam really, actually, that's what holding all the structure. Now between the beam, we're going to put, the cross T. So you can see between this beam to this beam, we have 4 feet distance. If you go from here, you can see between this beam to this beam, it's exactly 4 feet distance, okay? So we're going to put between of them a 4 feet cross T. There are two companies who are selling this structure, okay? One of them is Armstrong and the other one is USG. And my stuff that I purchase here is USG. So they're very, very similar. Here I have the protocol of really Armstrong that I work with, okay, to install the USG. But the reason I bought USG is because the old structure is USG, and the difference between of them is that, let me show you. This is a Armstrong cross T, okay? And let me show you the USG cross T is this. So if you look carefully between of them, you can see the difference here. Okay, that is the USG. This is the USG that I'm holding here, you can see it. And this is the Armstrong here. This is the Armstrong with the barcode here. The difference is here. Let me show you where's the difference. Here is the difference. You see the latch. The latch of Armstrong is a little bit bigger. Okay, and it's done in purpose that you cannot use, you won't be able to use Armstrong part to replace USG part. So that's the only difference between of them, okay? There are other differences between the color. You can see the color is white, but the Armstrong, the USG is a little bit off-white. So that's the difference between of both of them. So just remember, there are two companies, USG and Armstrong. They are the same, but you cannot mix both of them because it will not work. Just let you know. So now we can actually continue. Just to repeat what I'm saying, all this grid here that you can see is comprised from three elements, which is the wall molding, the main beam, and the cross T. Okay, the main beam can come only with 12 feet. The wall molding come with 12 feet only, and the T structure, or the cross T, sorry, come with 4 feet, 2 feet, and 12 feet as you need it. So here is the place where I want to add a cross T. So I want to show you here, there is a main beam, and here is another main beam. Difficult to see, now you can see it. Okay, and between the main beam, there is a 4 feet space. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to actually put here, but I want to show where exactly. Difficult to see, but here you see there is a hole here. There is already one cross T. This cross T actually connected to this. And now I'm going to put another cross T here in the same hole. So if you look carefully what I'm doing, I'm actually putting the other cross T in the same hole and just press it. It's going to be locked. As you can see, it's actually already inside here in the hole. So you can see here, if you look carefully, you can see one latch here from the other cross T, this cross T, and the other one is already coming from here, you see, which I press it inside and it's click. So now we have 4 feet. That's the the one that I'm actually holding in my hand here, it's here. So here I want to put another cross here, so you can see there is a 1, 2, 3, 4 hole, okay? The 4 hole meaning that it is 2 feet, because every one hole from here is actually half a feet. So here is the T cross that you can see here. What I'm doing, I'm just putting it here in the hole. You can see the hole here, and I just press it. You can hear it, that's it. So now it's actually already in. See, I put here 2 cross T, actually 3 cross T. Let me show you. This cross T that you see here, the longitude here, it's actually 4 feet. And this one and that one is 2 feet, okay? And you can see it's actually bending here. It's because I still did not finish here. But I want to show you how easy it clicked to the main bin, how easy the cross T is clicking to the main bin. Let me show you. Just put these cross T, as you can see here. Okay, very easy to insert them, and this one here. And as you can see here, you see I have here really a big hole. That is 4 feet by 2 feet. While here I have 2 feet by 2 feet. The reason is because I'm going to have here in this area, as you can see here. Okay, in this area I'm going to have a light here, a fluorescent light or LED light here, which is 4 feet by 2 feet. So that's why I actually put it here. While here I'm going to have a tile, a normal tile here. And here I'm going to have a normal tile. So let me show you from far away the way it looks. Okay, if you look here, you can see 2 square really, and the far is nothing but a rectangle 4 by 2. Okay, and I'm going to continue now, and I want to show how I'm actually doing it. It's so easy, you won't believe even, to just put it inside. So this is another cross T. It's actually 4 feet cross T here, and it's not really connected yet. You can see I can move it. But now what I want to do, I really want to put it in this hole you can see here, the diamond hole. What I have to do, I just have to press it. That's it. You hear the click? That's it. It's done. Very easy. So if you look here on the cross T, you can see that it's going flat until here, and then it's going in a curve. So this curve is going to be inside the panel of the other cross T. Let me show you. You see, if you look here, you don't see, you see how perfect it is, because the curve is going inside the other T cross T. This cross T, so this cross T curve going inside, and when it connected to the other cross T here. So that's why you don't see it anymore. So until now we actually put, you can see here the 2 square that we put before, and here is the rectangle 2 by 4 for the fluorescent light here. Okay, and here we have a rectangle, quite a big rectangle, which is 4 by 6 feet almost. What we're going to do here, we're going to put cross T 4 feet on the width of it, and on the longitude we're going to put 2 feet. So that's the way we're going to create here almost 6 rectangles 2 by 2 feet for the to address the tiles here. So here I install 1, 2, 3, 4 feet cross T here, but these two I really did not lock them, because I want to show you how to lock them. You see, it's not really locked, not this and not this. Okay, so what I want to do first I want to put here 2 feet on this width, 2 feet, in order to create 2 rectangles 2 by 2. See, like that. That's the first thing I have to do. So let me show you how I'm doing it. Okay, I'm taking these 2 feet cross T and I'm putting it here in a hole. Okay, here in this hole. And I just press it until it will go in. Okay, so it's in. And you can hear the click. Now I'm going to put it in a huddle cross T here.
Okay, so just press it and you just hear the click and that's it.
So from a close distance, what's happening here, we have actually two squares we create. Okay, and look at that, the weights look perfect. And here it's perfect, okay? And what happened here actually, you can see how it latch. If you look carefully here, okay, in this piece of metal, if you look here, a little bit difficult to see, but there is a piece of metal. I'll show you very soon how it's actually latched, okay? From here, I believe it's better. Yeah, you can see the piece of metal, it's here. Here's the piece of metal here, which actually latched to the other crusty, which is 4 feet crusty, this crusty. Here I have a crusty, which is a 2 feet crusty, okay? And I want to show you what's happening here. You see, this is the part that really connect, you know, this piece of metal here. Okay, but in this piece of metal, you have a bump. You see here, this piece, it's really a bump. And what happened, it can be close himself. So when he go inside to the other crusty, to the hole, the diamond hole there, it's actually latch, and he cannot get out. That's where you hear the click. Okay, so that's really what's happening here. So here I want to put another 4 feet crusty here. Let me show you from where to where. From here to this place, okay? But if I'm going to measure it, it's not 4 feet, it's actually 3.5 feet or so. And I just want to show you how I actually address this issue to put here a crusty that is actually less than 4 feet. So that's what happened when I'm putting a crusty. As you can see, it's 48 inches. So, but the distance between this point and this point here is actually 43.25. So we need to go and trim this crusty in order to fit here in this place. So that's what we're going to do next. So here is my 4 feet crusty that I want to trim. I'm actually holding it in my hand, but that's not the place where I'm going to trim it. If you go here and you look carefully, you can see here, I already mark 43.25 exactly here, here and in the back. Okay, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to actually cut it in order to fit this area, okay? Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut it here. As you can see, this is the first thing I'm going to use, this cutter here. And it's not going to be difficult, believe me or not. One. And the second one, it's here. Okay, so we make a cut here and here. And here is the funny thing here. We're not going to cut it straight, we're going to give it a little bit of angle here because sometimes the wall is not really straight. So we're going to cut it from here. Okay. So this is cut. Now you need to be careful for metals here, I need to use gloves. Now if you look at it, it's not very straight here, but remember that's going to be in, it's going to be inside on the molding, okay? I can actually give it a little bit of push here with a plier just to make it straight, okay? And now I'm going to install it. So just put it here, okay? And it's not really latched yet, it's not installed. But what I have to do here, I want to show you, you see, here is the hole that I have to put it here. See, there is already one crusty here going to this hole. And this is the crusty you can see here is going to this hole. That's going to be the second crusty that going to this hole. And what I need now, I actually need to press it. Unfortunately, I cannot do it with one hand, so I will have to press it myself and show the result. But really what you have to do, you have to just push it in until you hear a click, and that's what's happening. After that, it's actually going in. And if you look here, okay, you can see here on this latch, where is the metal here? Let's say put it here. So what you can see here is a piece of metal which is here. You see this piece of metal here? That piece of metal, you see, it will go in, it will click. This small piece of metal. Okay, it's going to this hole and then it will click. So that's what you have to do. So in this hole that you see here, there are two cross T connected here. One is this cross T and that's the other cross T here. Let me show you how the weights look from down, from here, from down here, from the floor. And that's the weights look. And by the way, if you look at that, this is a little bit crooked because the person who removed it before, and by mistake, bent this main beam. This is the main beam. So I have to fix it. And it's actually look okay now from here. So here I have a cross T, 2 feet cross T. As you can see here, you can see it. And I'm going to put it here in order to create the 2 feet by 2 feet rectangle. So here is the cross T. It's actually almost 4 feet cross T that I just installed. As you remember, you can see here I cut it here, and now what I'm going to do, I'm going to install the cross T, the 2 feet cross T here in this hole. Okay, so here you have one hole here, and here is a second hole. So the distance on a cross T between holes is exactly 1 foot. So that is the second hole, which is the 2 feet. And what I'm going to take these, you can see it here, and just push them in. Okay, I have to use two ends here to show what I'm doing. So here what I'm doing, I'm actually putting it here first, and I just press it. You can hear the tick, left, so I can move it here, but then I have to put it in the other hole here, okay? And that's it. So if you look here on this space, you can see there are missing cross T here between the beam here, okay, the main beam and the molding here, okay, number of them are missing, okay. But the problem here that the distance between the main beam and the wall is not 24 inch, it's actually 20 inch. So here is an old cross T that was there when we remove it. So let me show you the way it looked like. You have, okay, the ledge here, but here they cut it here a little bit slightly because sometimes the wall is not really straight, so they avoid it, you know, they just cut it from here to here. It's exactly 20 inch. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to put it there where it should be, which means it should be 2 feet from these cross T here. Here is the hole that you have to go to. You see, there is already a one cross T, but the other cross T, the one I show you, will go to this place here and will latch, okay? So basically, two cross T can go to the same hole. As you can see, the hole shape, if you look here, it's a diamond. Here is a hole. A hole that the cross T are going in, you can see it. So basically two cross T can go to this hole. So here is another cross T that I'm actually pressing. You see the hole here? Here is the hole, and what I'm doing is really push it in, okay? Until you hear the click. That's it. So you can hear that, you hear the click, correct? And that's it, it's actually locked in. Same hole, you have two cross T, as you can see from down here. Here's the cross T I just put, okay? And this is the other cross T, and you can see here in the connection, actually, there is one cross T here, and the other one is here. Both of them, okay, it's actually 2 feet. And they're actually connected to the same hole, diamond hole there. So that's the way this grid works. So in this area, as you can see from here at the end, there are five cross T are missing here, and I'm going to actually creating them now. So the first thing, I took the measurement between the main beam here
to the wall here, which is 20 inch.
So here are the five costi here. As you can see, it's a 2 feet. But remember, it's only 20 inch, so I just mark them here. Okay, and I'm going to cut them, all of them, in order to fit the location there that you saw before. So here is the mark where I have to cut. I'm taking these tools, as you can see here, and I just cut it here. Okay, and I cut it in the other size here. Difficult to see, but of course you can see it from here. Okay, I'm cutting it here. Okay. And then I have to cut it from here, which means I have to cut it some angle here. Okay, now just play with it a little bit. As you can see, it's already gone. Okay, so that's it. So this is the way it looks. Okay, after I cut it. Okay, so this is one. I'm going to cut all of them now in this manner, and then I'm going to install them in the place I showed you before. Here's another one. That's it. So here are the five cross tees I'm going to install now. You can see them here, and I can flip them to show you the way they look. Okay, that's the way they look here. Okay, and here. So you can see all of them are the same size. And I'm going to actually put them in the place you showed before. So here I install these five pieces, as you can see here. Very, very easy. And the distance between each of them is 2 feet. So here it is. And what left is the other side. You can see it from here. Let me go and show you what left here. So here is the area that we have maybe 1, 2, 3 pieces. And the interesting thing is that this piece between here, okay, to here, to the wall here, it's more than 2 feet. Okay, because the way that this grid has been designed, the side here and at the end of the wall are more than 2 feet. So it's no problem, because this probably is 2, 2.5 feet, and we have a tile that actually got 2 feet by 2.5 feet by 4 feet, so we can actually cut it and put it here. But here what you see, that's what we need to do now. We need to actually cut the crossti to fit this area. So here I cut 3 pieces, okay, 1, 2, 3. And all of them are actually USG company. That's a crossti 2 and 3, and you can see it's 25 1/4 each one of them. Okay, so this is the old one, and these both of them are the new one, the USG, and I'm going to install them. You see, one, here I'm going to install it, second I'm going to install it here, and the third I'm going to install here. Before I install it, I just want to talk about that cross T. You see, this is 2 feet cross T. This was 4 feet cross T that I have to cut, because the gap there, it's actually 25 1/4. Okay, so I cannot really use crossti of 2 feet here. Now you can see the difference between 2 feet and 4 feet. 4 feet, as you can see, there is a hole here, so you can actually install 2 feet through it. But in 2 feet, if you look, there is no hole here, so you can only pass them between 4 feet crossti here, or between the main beam Okay, so that is the difference here, and as you can see, I actually have to cut 4 feet cross T in order to fit in the other space there. So before I'm going to install it, I just want to share what's going to happen here. You see, imagine that this is the cross T that's going to the other cross T or to the main bin. Okay, you can see here there is a hole, a diamond hole here. What's going to happen here, you actually put this cross T that I have here in my hand, these 2 feet, and you just put it here and press it. And then you can hear the click, so that's it, and you have it here. So that's the way to work with it. Now if you want to remove it, it's quite easy, you just have to go here, and so it's tricky, but it can be done. And that's it, it's out. So this is the last cross T I'm going to install, and if you look at it here carefully, you can see here this area, you see that stuff, this gap here, that should go inside because I didn't push it in. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I hope I can use one end here. You can see it's going to this hole, and in this hole there is two, actually there is this going to be inside, and there is another cross T here already inside. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to press it. I hope you're going to hear the click. Okay. Not inside yet. So, yep, oh, that's it. So now it's inside. And how do you make sure it's inside? You go under. And you can see that the gap here that was already is not exist. Okay, and that's the way it's going to look from here. Okay, so this is the last cross T that I installed, and I install now this one. Okay, and you can see how nice it looks, and this one here. Okay, so all the grid really in this room is already installed. Okay, so the only thing we need to put here is the fluorescent light that's going to be here on the 2 feet by 4 feet. Okay, but before I'm going to do the fluorescent, I just want to talk about this place here. We have actually 2 feet by 2 feet plus by 25 and a quarter inch, which means 24 inch by 25 and a quarter inch rectangle. Okay, it's not a square, so what we have to do, we have to buy the 2x4 tile and trim this tile to fit these spaces here. That's what we have to do, and it's very easy to do. And you can buy 2x4, it's no problem, in Home Depot or Lowe's if you want. And by the way, I use USG, and there is also Armstrong. I use the USG grid. I like the USG grid, it's very nice. Armstrong is also okay, but remember, they are not compatible. And you can find USG in Home Depot.